Hello guys, welcome to our YouTube channel Cube Book. Today we are going to sum up new book whose name is The Facebook Effect. The Facebook Effect is the only official account of the history of the world's largest social network, explaining why it's so successful and how it's changed both the world of us. David Kirkpatrick was fascinated by Facebook early on. He started writing regular articles about the company in Fortune 10 years ago. 2 years later, he even got Mark Zuckerberg to officially cooperate on a book about Facebook's story. The result is this New York Times bestseller. For many of us, Facebook has become the default mechanism for sharing something we want to say. Messaging friends, solidifying new connections, and even a useful resource for irregular life events like finding flat. But how did that even happen? Why did Facebook become so successful and others like MySpace were left in the dust? David Kirkpatrick's notes. Here are some lessons from the history of Facebook to help you understand social media. First, part of Facebook's success comes from being in the right place at the right time. If you are politically active, Facebook is the best place to make yourself heard. We all have to change our perspective on privacy in today's world. Are you ready to witness the full power of Facebook effect? Here we go. Lesson number first. Facebook came to the exact right place at the exact right time. The difference between $1 million company and a $1 billion company is often as little as a few month time or a few thousand miles of distance. Friendster and MySpace were not bad. They were just too early to reach critical mass or too slow to innovate. Other sites like Eons targeted the wrong people. A social media site for over 50 years old in 2006, really. In the case of Facebook, timing, location, everything came together. First, broadband internet access was just starting to spread in 2004. When Facebook was launched, this was crucial because photo upload would later become core function of Facebook. So, people needed faster uploading and downloading speeds. Not only that, the sheer number of internet users was also sharply on the rise, more than doubling in the first 6 years the company was around, from less than 1 billion to over 2. Second, in restricting Facebook to college campuses, Mark Zuckerberg picked the perfect spot for his network to spread. Many league schools tried to put their campus communities online at the time, and college students are among the most socially active groups of people as is. So, they more than welcome this new way of connecting. Also, being at Harvard, he had access to some of the world's brightest minds who would help him build the team the company needed to become that big in the first place. Lesson second, if you are not into politics, or if you are into politics, then Facebook is the great place to hang out at and make yourself heard. You can easily tell that Facebook is really politics content driven by opening our news feed anytime between August and November every 4 years. All you'll see are posts about present presidential candidates. The reason Facebook can be used so well by political activists is what it's like an organized rally or protest, except that it's cheaper, safer, and faster. In 2008, people in South Africa form a Facebook group against the brutal drugs raid in and mistreatment of citizens therein, garnering 3,000 members in just 2 days. The group organized a protest march and a petition about, but also consistently shared updates, photos and videos of the ongoing raids, which got a lot of people to file complaints. This resulted in an investigation into matter by the country. And looking back at Hillary versus Trump, it's been clear ever since Obama won the Facebook election in 2008 by outshining John McCain on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter and pretty much everywhere else online, that even the most powerful people in the world are now voted for online. Lesson third, our views on privacy are changing thanks to Facebook, and they have too. Let's say you are suddenly in charge of hiring an intern. After a few days, you have a stack of resumes on your desk. What's the first thing you do after looking at the pictures? If there is one, of course. Hey, let's check this guy's Facebook. See if he has some drunk pics. Before social media, you could be the most serious carpenter, the most discreet hairdresser, or the most reputable banker in the town, and still live a crazy punk rock band, magic trick birthday performer, hard rock biker, life in your spare time. But now you can't. Facebook's changed all that. You only have one real name, one true identity, and Facebook forces you to show all of it. Sure, you could try to keep things off the platform or hide some of them, but when there is not enough information, people always assume the worst. So it will hurt your reputation either way. Zuckerberg's big bet on this is that we will change what is considered normal to be public. The more people publicly speak about depression, crazy hobbies and taboo topics, the more we will perceive those discussions as normal. We want all the upsides of being ever connected. To get it, we will have to embrace the transparency that's come with it too. So this is the summary of the Facebook effect. The book is written by David Kirkpatrick. Thanks for listening. The summary of the Facebook effect.